morning, I'm John Kynaston from Run to the Hills and this is the Hardmoors 55. Normally this race is in March, but there's nothing normal about this year, so it's now on the 24th of October and we're doing a time trial moor, so we're setting off. The first runners are already away and I'm off at 8:46. So I hope you enjoy my video diary of this year's Hardmoors 55.
So you arrive, you get your temperature taken, give in your drop bags there, and then everyone's socially distanced, just waiting for their start time, and then we get called to get our tracker and then we're heading off.
No.
So how are we doing, Andy?
Yeah, pretty happy. Surprisingly windy at the start, which is in the valley, so it'll be interesting when we get up on the hills to see what's up there, but no, happy, really good.
We've got our tracker and our race number and then heading up to the start now.
Our heart goes up, our heart goes down. We fall in love and we fall back out. I'll give you anything you want, anything you want, anything, anything. Just don't tell me no, you stop it still. Then you make it rush. You're like a pill that I just can't trust. You tell me to stop, but I keep on going. Tell me to stop, but I keep on going. Tell me to stop, but I keep on going. Keep on, keep on, keep on. You'll never stop this day. I will never let you go. Well, who am I to say? Maybe by now you should know. You got your somebody calling. You think you're somebody, don't you? I think you're scared. Somebody close. You'll never stop this day. I will never let you go. Wasn't it enough? Or did I move too far? It's all too much. I think I must be mad to give you everything I had. Everything I had. Everything, everything. But it still went bad. Tell me to stop, but I keep on. But I keep on going. Tell me to stop, but I keep on going. Keep on, keep on, keep on. You'll never stop this day. I will never let you go. Well, who am I to say? Maybe by now you should know. You got your somebody calling. You think you're somebody, don't you? I think you're scared of keeping somebody close.
To Kildale, and this is where the checkpoint is normally. Andy, you often marshal here, don't you?
Yeah, it's a lovely space. Go in there, have a tea and a bit of pizza. Sat around waiting for people to come through. Not this year though.
No, not today. So we've been going, according to my watch, 11.02, 2.5 hours.
Yeah.
So now we've got about a mile and a half climb, haven't we?
Yeah, straight up the hill.
Yeah. Sarah's pushing ahead of us here. And so far it's been dry, been quite windy, and the wind's been in our face, which always makes it a bit harder, but it's nice, dry and clear, so all good.
Thank you, man.
Ready.
in reverse. I'll keep running to the place where I belong. When you go to turn down the light, no one's there to hold you in the night. I'll keep running to the place where I belong. When you feel.
Yeah. Okay, thank you very much.
Taxi and water over the road.
I'm still coming
home. Okay, thank you.
When our picture fades in the sun, and all the colors blur in the one.
For 22.34 miles, 5 hours 26, and we're just climbing up the third of the three sisters.
I'll keep running to the place where I belong. When you think you're on your own, I'm still coming home. When your heart gets blinded, when you fall with the car.
That was a heavy, heavy rain shower for about half an hour. So, but thankfully it seems to stop now and it's a bit brighter again. Okay, been going for 26.73 miles, so almost halfway. And 6 hours 40. So I would say, I'm not really thinking too much about the end, but that's almost halfway. 6:40, so 12, 13, 20. If I did even halves, I do think the second half is slightly easier than the first half. But obviously you've done 6.5 hours, so you're not as fresh. But it's nice that the rain has stopped.
Okay,
and, just a update. Been going for 32.71 miles and 8 hours 19. So just gone through Osmotherley and we're just climbing out now and heading up to Square Corner. I stopped at Osmotherley just to sort out. I needed to change the battery on the camera and my watch needed charging as well, so I've got the battery pack out. So Sarah and Andy just went past me, so they're somewhere ahead, but hopefully I'll catch them on the climb up here. So still feeling good. It's been drizzling a bit for the last few minutes, but basically still moving well and feeling positive.
I'll never stop fighting to get.
Thanks for watching the video of my Hardmoors 55 race. If you want just the short version, I finished and I've got my medal and my t-shirt for finishing the Hardmoors 55 in 14 hours, 22 minutes and 35 seconds. If you want the slightly longer version of what happened over the last few hours, then basically I caught up with Andy and Sarah after Osmotherley Square, Square Corner. And they'd stopped to put on some warmer clothes. Sarah was putting some over trousers on, I think, and Andy was putting another layer on. And I was starting to get cold, but could I just caught them, I decided I'd be okay. And it was a big, big mistake. It just goes to show, doesn't it? This is my 52nd ultra, and you can still make mistakes while I can. And so basically over the next 40, 45 minutes, I just felt really cold and chilled. Plus the fact that I'd not eaten too much over the last hour or so. So I think my energy levels, whether psychologically or physically, were starting to go down a bit. And so I did struggle a bit. And I know when I'm finding things hard because I don't talk much and I probably didn't say much over that next 45 minutes or so. And I hung on to Andy and Sarah as much as I could, but I realized I really had to stop and put some warm clothes on. But instead of doing it halfway along that section, I decided to keep on going. I knew I needed to get my head torch out as well. So I made it to where you go through the gate into the woods. And Andy was there and he was opening the gate. And I said, oh, I'm going to stop here. And he said, do you want a hand? I said, no, I'm fine. And they went on. And to be honest, I didn't see him again. So I stopped. They must have stopped for a good 6, 7, 8 minutes. Kind of needed to take my bags off, my coat off, get my merino wool top out, put that on, coat back on, everything else, and got some food out. And quite a few people went past me, and I would say over the next half an hour or so, I still felt quite cold, and it took me a while just to get going again. I eventually got to the last checkpoint with about 14 miles to go. I had a milkshake there and my yogurt, and I spent a few minutes there just getting myself organized to run the last 14 miles. And I would say over the last 14 miles, I just tried to keep going. I wanted to finish well. I wanted to finish comfortably, so I didn't want to push too hard. So I basically walked most of it. I ran the bits where I could, where it was flat or downhill. And I just tried to keep a steady pace going. One of the good things about knowing the route pretty well is that there's certain landmarks which I knew were coming next. So I just basically went from landmark to landmark and got through those. By the time I got to White Horse and the last checkpoint, I knew there was just 9 miles to go, and I break that up into three 3 mile sections. So I get to Cold Kirby, and then there's a bridge on the road, and there's the end. And I just tried to concentrate on keeping going as best I could. Quite a few people went past me. I caught maybe a few people, not too many. But I just tried to feel as comfortable as I could and finish as well as I could. To be honest, I wasn't too worried about the time, which is just as well, because it's almost 5 hours slower than my best time on that course, which as I get older, it is quite hard to come to terms, if I'm honest. You know, I've done this race in 2015 in 9 hours 36, so to take almost 14 and a half hours feels long, but that's where it is, and that's where I am at the moment. So anyway, I got there, I finished, and I felt okay. I felt a bit sore and stiff, but within a day or two I feel as though I've been moving okay. I've not ran since. It's now Thursday afternoon. And I'm still just, I'm gonna have a run on Saturday, I think, because the South Downs Way 100 is just a week later. So yeah, I accomplished what I wanted to do, but probably at a bit slower pace. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed watching this race video of the 2020 Hardmoors 55 race, and I will be back because I don't want this to be my final race on this course. I think I can still go faster, so I'm gonna put a bit more effort in next time and see if I can go quicker again. Okay, so thanks for watching, and this was John Kynaston from Run to the Hills.